So this morning we shot a video for Dragman's Facebook, and I got to shoot a machine gun, but I'm really bad at aiming, so that's something that I hope to improve on.
Do not get me on camera, Mike. I will fuck you up.
I think you should add that in the bloopers on the end. My niece Emily is working at Dragon Man's for the summertime. I just brought her lunch.
So I sold two guns today, and don't tell my mom, but I'm not going back to college. This is like the best job ever.
I got all this stuff from shootingtarget7.com. Watch how fast I throw this together for you. Voila! I got my new target stand from shootingtarget7.com. They're yellow zinc plated. These are half inch plates. You can also get them in 3/8. These brackets lock the target plate onto the swing arm. These are half inch AR500 steel and can withstand a hit from a 50 BMG. 2 inches all the way to 8 inches. I absolutely love it. It's easy to assemble. They're having a huge sale. I think you can get this whole setup half inch for $350, I believe. We'll have a link in the description below on where you can get your own. I'm going to show you two of the most well-known handguns. First, of course, is my favorite, the Desert Eagle. In over like 500 movies, probably in every video game that has a gun in it. Fantastic, fantastic design. And the 44 Red Hawk Ruger. It was really first kind of made its debut during Dirty Harry, except that was a Smith & Wesson, but kind of along the same line. The Desert Eagle is the most powerful semi-automatic handgun. This one is chambered in the 50 AE. It has fixed barrel, a gas-operated slide, and an M16 style bolt. One of the only handguns that does that. Because of the fixed barrel, it's very accurate. It's really good for target shooting. It's also good for hunting, but it's pretty heavy. It's 4.5 pounds, and that's without the ammo. This is the Ruger Red Hawk Hunter series 44 mag. The reason why they call it the Hunter is because they have these little notches on the barrel where you can actually put a pistol scope on there. I prefer no scope. The iron sights are great. The Ruger Red Hawk is about 3.5 pounds, which makes it more suitable for hunting. This is what the rounds look like. There's the 50 and there's the 44 mag. All right, so let's load it up. I'm gonna shoot the baby first. I brought my new targets from Shooting Target 7. Here we go with the Ruger Red Hawk 44. Got a hell of a kick. Let's see what this does to some soda bottles. Well, definitely has a lot of energy. Just for comparison, let's shoot it with the 9mm. You know, definitely not as much energy as the 44. All right, now let's try the beast, the Eagle. Was actually designed by an American company to start with, and then Israel actually was the one that started producing it. All right, you ready? Okay, let's see if I can hit the target with this beast. Alright, now I'm gonna try to hit the soda. Well, it looks like my targets held up really good, and we were shooting them, you know, pretty close with a very high caliber. Looks good. I think I'm gonna shoot at it some more with a smaller caliber. My wrist can only withstand so much of that blow. Don't forget to hit subscribe, hit the notification button so you can get emails from us. Thanks for watching. Find us on Facebook and Instagram. Have a great Memorial Day. God bless America, and God bless all the men and women who died for our country, who gave us the freedoms for us to come out and shoot weapons like that. Thank you very much. Probably wouldn't be able to hit the golf ball. What do you think? Probably not. This sucker kicks like a mule. Oh, let me try the... Oh, we're still hitting them. Let me try the cameras. Definitely kicks like a mule. The Desert Eagle. After you shot this thing, you definitely know that you shot a gun.